There has been a knocking, 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 knocking. Oh my god, I'm so sorry guys. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Austin Matha. If this is the first time here, you are most definitely welcome. In fact, you are here for the real deal, okay? Because today is the day I talk about the knocking, okay? Guys, you know, you are aware that I was stuck at the airport and nothing could be done. It was actually raining here in Lagos, so they had to delay our flight by 1 hour 30 minutes. We finally boarded the plane at about 8:30 something, okay, so that you understand. But while I was at the airport, I was trying to catch up with the Friday Arena games, but lo and behold, that is not even what I was meant to be watching. Hell, chin. When I was on the aircraft, things were happening. I don't even know if it was when I was on the aircraft. It was when I came down and I was now stuck on the road because there were no roads, they had blocked up the roads. Guys, I finally got home at about 12 a.m. or about 11:40 something. That's when I got home. So I went to bed only for innocent me to wake up this morning. And all I could see around Twitter is Katrina's Nash and praises Nash. They have knack. Guys, what? First of all, I want to thank all the people I retweeted their tweets on Twitter, because if not for them, I would have been heartbroken. Oh, I see Katrina now, she dey move. Oh my god, guys. Okay, no, better just relax yourself and give people the gist. Guys, the housemates had a truth or dare session last night, okay? And let me tell you, this truth or dare session, they've been planning it since on Thursday, okay? Since on Thursday evening. And it was Praise that was championing the conversation. Hey, guys, okay, first, after they finished playing their Friday Arena games, Praise was the only housemate to complete the task. Now, what did Biggie ask them to do? Biggie asked them to carry empty Montana containers, you know, those canned malts. Let's assume that this is Camot. And let's assume that this is a ruler. Okay? So he told them to take the Camot and put it like this. And be going. Make sure that the can does not fall. If it falls, you start all over again. And guys, none of them even got it. In fact, Erica was cheating because her hand was very close to the keg like this. She was holding it like this. I say, Erica. They say, put your hand like this. And see, carry her own. Go put for where the... for where the container day. I said, okay, no problem. Let us watch it. Whether Biggie is blind. Immediately she finished, Biggie said, Erica, I never knew you to be a cheat. And I was like, exactly. You cheated. In fact, let's just leave this Friday Arena games. Okay, let's talk about what happened after the Friday Arena games. Guys, so like I told you, Prince has been shouting since Thursday, if you know that if they dare you, you will not do it, please don't come to the room. We are going to lock this room. The only people that should come into this room are people that will do anything. This time around, nothing is off the table. We are going to ask anything. We are going to do anything. Ebuka said we were boring, so we need to, you know, make things happen. I say, okay now. Better you are not going to miss this one. Lo and behold, I missed it. In fact, I didn't even know when it happened. But like I said, Twitter gave me all the information I needed. Guys, the theme for this their truth or dare is what? The dark room. Yes, the dark room. And you know that when the room is dark, things are bound to happen there. Things are bound to happen in any dark room. And this one was no exception. Now let me just tell you guys some of the ones I saw on Twitter, because like I said, I did not watch it. But anyone I open my mouth to mention to you, just know that I have watched the video on Twitter, because if I do not see proof, if I don't have receipt, I will not talk about it, okay? So these few ones that I'm going to mention, I have it on my Twitter. So if you don't know my Twitter account, just look at the name of this channel, Austin Better. Go and type it there on Twitter, at Austin Better. You will see the tweets that I retweeted, the ones that gave us, you know, confirmed info, okay? Now the first one is Ozo and Dorothy. Kaisha actually dared Ozo to grab the boobs, to grab our milk factory, you know, to press it. I say, Chinekina, me. Dorothy even wanted Ozo to drink a shot, but the boy said, no, this is not the time to be taking shots. This is a time to possess your word, your possession. Now, so Baba put hand under the breast. That's when Kayode now knew that he was going to remove it. People don't swear for Kayode on Twitter. They say he's going to suffer for 600 years. I say, you will leave the boy alone now. Leave the boy alone. But Sha, I saw him when he grabbed the breast like this. They now removed it. But I shall manage to get a screenshot. I'm going to see if I'll insert it here. Also, I was so excited. Like, he was just spending sheepishly. I said, that's where they will find you. That is where they will find you. Another one that I saw a lot of people talking about on Twitter was the one where they dared Katrina to go and fondle, to go and, you know, just familiarize herself with Uncle Lekos Dadio, you know, and she went there willingly and decided to caress the, you know, in fact, yesterday, forget everything when I watch for Twitter, I miss. Myself, I don't say I don't miss. But thanks to Twitter. Twitter never fails, never tweet. Okay, guys, I know at this point you are staring at my nails. Yes, up, up, voila. What are you going to do about it? See, let's just forget about these other things and focus on the reason why I turned on this camera. And focus on the reason why you yourself, you are here. Because you know that you want to hear this thing that I want to say. I'm sure that you probably watched it. I'm sure that you have probably watched other YouTubers' videos. But you are here because you know that Beta is the queen of decoding. I am Ahunye at the sittings. And you know it. Let me just tell you. Katrina and Praise, they had a conversation on Thursday. So let me explain to you how this knocking came to be, because there was a knocking. Yes, there was a knocking. Now on Thursday, after their wager task and everything, you know, they went inside, you know, Praise was in the room, Katrina was in the room, Dorothy was in the room, Trickity was also in the room. They were having a conversation. And the whole conversation was majorly between Praise and Katrina. And the whole argument was the fact that Katrina made it known to Praise that she actually likes him. Now for her, she was like, Praise, I liked you. In fact, I still like you. And I made it known to you that the reason I like you, or one of the reasons I actually like you, is because you're proud of your craft. You guys know that Praise is a stripper. She's like, look, I like the fact that you own up to what you're doing. You're not embarrassed about it. You're not ashamed of it. And I really like that. And I still like you. And my brother, Praise, was just sitting on the bed, confused. You know, because when he opened his mouth to talk, he was not making any sense. And Katrina was like, the thing is, you're always rubbing it in our faces that, oh, you have somebody outside, you have this one outside, da 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 da. And he's like, look, I just wanted to be honest. I didn't want any situation where, you know, we'll now come out of the house, people will now say I lied. He was like, initially, he didn't want to talk about his child or the person he's engaged to and all of that. But then when he came into the house, he just decided to be honest about it. And I'm like, better for you, because if you don't tell us about it, we are going to dig it out. Especially not with all the pictures of your son that you have. We will dig it out, we will sniff it out. When we have long noses like this, what do you think we use it for? Sniff teeth, okay? Anyways, they had that conversation. And then Prince now managed to make small sense. You know, but then from what he was saying, you could tell that he himself, he likes Katrina. You know, he was like, look, I'm not saying that we cannot have anything together. If you like me, it's okay. You know, it's okay. I'm like, what is wrong with son? What is wrong with this one? Point is, two of them agree that they like one another. And you know, Dorothy and Trickity were just there cracking my ribs. They were like, okay, it's fine. You people have agreed that you like yourselves. Can you move closer now and have this conversation? Can you move closer now and have this conversation? Leave us the single people alone. And then Trickity was like, yes, so you should leave us that don't have spec alone. We are specless in this house. And then Dorothy was trying to console him, don't worry. We have a long queue of people that want us, you know, our spec. A long queue outside the house, so don't worry yourself. Now fast forward to this night when the knocking happened. I just really wanted you guys to have an idea that before now they had had a conversation. And I get the fact that Praise was high, okay, because Big Brother specifically told the housemates to make sure they pamper him as the winner of the Friday Arena Games. You know, in fact, Lucy was in bikini. Hell, she made better. I'm not angry. Lucy was in bikini. Now, these people had drank and drank and drank and drank. But Biggie specifically told them that they should make sure not to take any of the alcohol inside the house. You know, so they were outside drinking. Kaisha, I don't tire for that game. You know, say last week, now so she just they drink, like say now water. This time around again, now so she they drink. But that's not my business. As long as you do not know, you're not interested to me at this point. People that are interested to me at this point are Katrina and Praise. So they went into the room. These two people were on the same bed, my brothers and sisters. Under the duvet, my brothers and sisters. Praise was now looking around to see if there's anybody looking. I said, bros, calm down. Calm down. This is what they watch now. They watch out for Twitter. Now I'm saying, people see you. People see you. You knock. You knock. Baba Jo, they turn their head to see if anybody day, when he now saw that there was nobody there, he now used the duvet to cover himself and Katrina. Next thing, there was a knocking. In fact, Katrina was just moaning. See, this particular moaning tweet, I have it on my Twitter page. No, it is there. You know, she was moaning. Their body movement was Igbin. I said, Charlie, better. You don't be so. Guys, that's not even the part that got me laughing. The part that got me laughing was the part where after they finished knocking, they now removed the duvet. You know, Prince was just on the bed like this. You know, when you finish having a very good meal and you decide to relax, that's how Prince was on the bed. Next thing, we saw movement. Katrina's leg was moving. Guess what baby girl was doing with her leg? She was using her leg to drag her pants, you know, so that nobody will see her when she's trying to do it. You don't know that. The things we know are more than the things that you know at this point, because you are at our mercy. I am Hunyelile. We are seeing all these things. Okay? And somebody actually recorded that. In fact, Kayode was the first person to see her because he was the one that allowed us to watch it. Even though he did not allow us to watch the knocking completely, I don't know what is wrong with that boy, but then we understand, okay? Michelle saw when she was trying to drag her pants, she now dragged the pants slowly under the duvet. I said, see you now, see you. See, the one that will pay me is when they now come out now and tell me that they did not knock. They were fellowshipping, they were praying together. I will slap anybody when come outside and tell me that thing. Because now, so they knock for paper them. They come outside and tell me, say, they were not doing anything. I leave her. This one, if anybody come, I have receipts. I have receipts, and I know that a lot of people have the same receipts, so they should not even try it. Boss lady and engaged prince have nakalized things together. And the thing is, boss lady says she likes older men. That's why Twitter has even been on fire. Auntie, Prince is not an old man now. Prince is a young, vibrant youth. And the youth are talking about also told us that he's engaged, about to be married. Well, I don't know how they're going to explain these things to us when they come out for their interview, because my ears shall be like this. But anyways, that's for that. Now let's talk about Erica. I remember telling you guys that Erica was like, oh, she's tired of Biggie's house, she wants to leave this one, that one. Mama chop kiss yesterday night. He chop kiss, forget say he won't go house. She had a talk with Kidwire last night, yeah, and they talked about a lot of things. You know, she was like, look, Kidwire, I know that you're a flirt. I know that you like being around women. But the thing is, I cannot help myself. I don't know. I've been trying to help myself, but the thing is not working. And you know, before we knew it, they started chopping kiss. I think Nengi even had to bring them a blanket, you know, just to make things senge menge. You know, when they now covered themselves with the blanket, what we just hearing was, I see Nawa. This kiss has been a long time coming. Okay? This kiss don't the hungry kid boy have since, and it don't the hungry Erica. Finally, the kiss have come to pass. Can we get an amen? Anyways, the last one that now happened was the fact that Prince finally asked Nengi out last night. And guess what? Nengi said no. Now let me just tell you, yeah, I know that Nengi actually likes Prince. I know that there's this whole thing with her and Prince and also, you know, but let's just talk about her and Prince, okay? I know that Nengi actually likes Prince, or it is safe to say that she enjoys Prince company, you know, because after they had their Thursday wager task and everything, that Biggie now scolded Nengi for whispering and all of that, she was really upset with Prince for not standing by her and trying to console her and just be there for her. Because they had a conversation that same Thursday night after Prince and Katrina had their own talk. They themselves, they had their own talk, but they were in the garden. You know, they were sitting on that bed alone talking, and then she was like, you, I'm angry with you. You're no more my friend, so you couldn't wait for me, this one, that one. And then Prince was like, okay, I'm sorry. She's like, no, I don't like you again. You know how when you meet a guy that you really like, and you know, you're still trying to be a baby girl, but you're still trying to make him know that, yes, I like you, but we have to take things slow. That was the vibe I was getting from her. And you know, on Prince's side too, I could tell that he really liked her, because he was really smiling. I was like, okay, I'm sorry. She's like, no, I don't like you again. He's like, you, I know you like me. And she's like, no, I'm just using you to pass time. You know that, I mean, I don't like sleeping early, so I'm using you to pass time. Then the boy wanted to stand up and go inside jokingly, and she was like, I'm joking. You could tell that she really enjoys Prince's company, but the problem is that she has somebody outside, according to her, and she doesn't want to disrespect the person, which explains why she's saying no to almost all the guys. It's not to say that she doesn't really like anybody, but I mean, she's trying to play her games right. And again, you wouldn't really blame her, because you're not in the situation that she talked about, okay? Her boyfriend did not even know that she was coming into Biggie's house. He was never in support, so she doesn't really know their stand outside. Now, coming into the house and messing things up would just be too much, you know, so she's trying to be careful, so we need to just cut her some slack. Okay? But the only bad side about this whole thing is that people have finished praise. You know, they were yabbing him that you know that also like the girl. This one, that one. I'm like, people should leave the boy alone. It's his feelings. It's his emotions. Let him express himself. Now that he has gotten a no, he will move on. And guys, he actually took it well. Because he was cool, calm and collected. He's Mr. Nigeria. You know, he was poised about the whole thing. So saying no to him did not mean that he was going to go inside and start crying. Okay? Anyways, that's all the gist I have for you guys in this particular video. I hope you enjoyed watching it. If you did, please don't forget to give me a very big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed. And of course, if you want to see some of these clips, head on to my Twitter account. Follow me there as well. My name is Austin Better on every platform, in fact. Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, okay? That's my name. I'm proud of the name, okay? Thank you guys so much. And I will definitely see you guys on the next one. Bye, guys.